Hey everybody. Bowler Guns 5000. Back with more Final Fantasy 4. Oh man, what the heck is going on with the screen? Where am I? Rydia! Gilbert! Yong! I'm alone. Well, that sucks. In the last episode, if you remember, that was like so long ago, we were on the ship, we got attacked by a left. Dude! Let me reminisce in peace, bitch. Okay. We were on the ship, right? We got attacked by Leviathan, now we're here. And who knows where this is. Mysidia? Uh-oh. Oh no, this isn't good. If you remember, Mysidia is the place that Cecil helped pillage and plunder right before the opening of the game. So, probably not gonna be too welcome here. The Devil Road is a mysterious dimensional road. Traveling this road drains a lot of vital energy, hence its name. Oh, I didn't read the text, man, and he's casting Totemy, and you don't know why. Well, I need to talk to him again anyway to get him to get rid of it. You son of a bitch! You're that damned Dark Knight! Take this! Holy cow, this guy's voice is annoying. Toad! Man, that voice is bad. Wow. Anyway. Dude, we're moving around. I have nothing to say to you. Get the hell away from me. Yeah, that's fair, I suppose. I like that the white mages don't hold grudges. I mean, that's probably like part of their training is that they're made to be totally unbiased. Jewel shop. I'm surprised you actually sell stuff to me. Considering who I am and what I did. Jeez. The cafe. Are you gonna dance for me? Look, watch me dance. You are. Oh, wait, oh. What's it with this music, though? I mean, I'm digging the dance, but what's with the music? What? Oh, I feel kind of sleepy. Uh-oh. Did you drug me? Good grief. Holy cow. What? I'm a pig. What the fuck? Ha ha, he he, ho ho. Sui! What? Okay, you're weird. Nah, I'm a pig. Look at my derpy pig body. I think I'm just gonna stay like this. This is Devil World that leads to Baron. To guard against future invasions, we sealed it off. Why do men hurt other men? Because we're douchebags. Oh, it's Baron's Dark Knight! Oh, no. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, it's Baron's Dark Knight. It's just the exact same thing again. He just jumps back further into the... How did you recognize me? I'm a fucking pig. Does my pig look incredibly distinct from other pigs? Do you know how much we've suffered because of you? Yes. No. Mate, kinda. You bastard. You've got a lot of guts coming here. Yeah. Well, it wasn't exactly my choice, but I agree with you. Tower of Prayers. You! You're that Dark Knight! What have you come to destroy this time? My name is Cecil, and I was the head of Baron's airship force. I came here before as a coward. I couldn't bring myself to disobey the King's orders. Now I come seeking forgiveness. Even if you apologize, it won't bring back the people you murdered. However, I sense a faint glimmer of light within you that was not there before. It might be worth listening to what you have to say. I'm fighting Golbez, the man who is controlling Baron. When my friends and I tried to prevent the theft of the Wind Crystal, he kidnapped one of us. We were going to save her, but Leviathan attacked us, and now...
You lost your friends. It seems fate has chosen you to endure this trial, and fate brought you back here. You seek to destroy a great darkness, but as long as you rely on the Dark Sword, you cannot defeat true evil. Your soul is stained with the darkness of your deeds. Evil is like a cancer. It spreads, consuming the soul entirely. You can become as evil as the man you seek. Yeah, it's called He Who Fights Monsters. If you wish for your faint glimmer to become a radiant light, then go to Mount Ordeals in the east. But I must save my friend! If you truly cherish this friend, you will endure this trial and be bathed in the purifying light of redemption at the summit. You must renounce your dark sword and receive the power of a holy knight. A paladin! Oh, damn. Be warned, though, many have sought to become a paladin. They tried and failed? Oh no, they tried and died! But you seem to carry a great destiny. What do you say? Will you go? Yeah? Duh. I mean, the game isn't going to progress unless I do. Nobody's ever made that joke before. But your dark soul will have little effect on the monster of the mountain. I'll send magicians with you. Palum! Barum! Oh, jeez, who are these guys? What's wrong? Where's Palum? Jeez, Palum, not again. What? Oh, hello. Jeez, man. So you're that guy from Baron, huh? The old man ordered me to help you. Guess I don't have a choice. You better be grateful. Oh, boy. These two? Correct. These two are the twin magicians, Palum and Porum. They're young and still in training, but they possess power far beyond their years. Damn straight! I'm gonna help you, so you better be grateful. You already said that! Palum, what have I told you about arrogance? You're Mr. Cecil, aren't you? I'm very pleased to make your acquaintance. Well, at least you're well-mannered. Hey, Palum, go ahead and greet him. Pleased to meet you, pal! What are you, Gumshoe? You're not Gumshoe, you're Palum. Palum, what a stupid... It's the pal. Palum. It's like palm, the warmth of her palm. Now go to Mount Ordeals. Palum, Porum, I'm counting on you. I can't believe I was a pig for that entire conversation. If you become a paladin, I will trust you. That's reasonable, I suppose. Go find out. Find out whether you can accept the light. And I'll do that. Man. Oh, I'm gonna switch to Porum, because Porum's awesome. Hello, Senor. I'm gonna be a pig. The paladin is a holy knight, the opposite of a dark knight. Yeah, I knew that. Maybe you didn't. Maybe somebody watching didn't. I shouldn't be like, oh, I knew that. You don't need to tell me that. Now, can I find that? Here's that guy that uses Toad on you. He become a paladin? Yeah, right. Oh, no! He's not going to use it on me anymore. I need to use... Do I have any diet food? No. Oh, no. I don't have any diet food. But now that I've seen that scene, he's not going to use Toad on me again. That's not good. Do you have diet food here? No! What? You don't have diet food? What the hell am I gonna do? I'm a freaking pig, man! I don't think this goes away if you just sleep. Never forgive the Baronian pillage that robbed us of the crystal and lives of people. Oh good, I'm glad that's on the wall. Please, huh? You're gonna come out our deals? What? I did not follow. You a paladin? Ha! Hell, I can be one too! That was an awkward sentence. You become a paladin? Hee hee ha ha hoo hoo. Ha ha hee hee hoo hoo. Palum, Porum, don't trust this man. You know, I'd be indignant, but you are pretty much totally right. Welcome, my knight is 200 gil, will you be saying? Hey, so finally, somebody who doesn't recognize me underneath this piggy exterior. Good night, sleepy pig. Jeez. Is that gonna go away? Yes, thank goodness. I walk in and she's like, oh my gosh, it's you! Security! I don't know. Before you leave, actually. The thing about this, okay. I don't know how obvious it's been made in the game, but we are going off to have Cecil become a paladin, and once Cecil becomes a paladin, none of his old gear will work anymore. So I'm going to buy. I think you get a sword. I don't think you need to worry about getting a sword, so I don't need to buy a weapon. I could probably stand to pick up some stuff for Paladin Porum though. What do they have equipped? You've got a plumed hat, leather, iron bangle. That's alright. You've got rod, plumed hat, leather, iron bangle. Yep. You have anything better? You have Gaia robes. Hell yeah. What? Why aren't you guys wearing this stuff already? Holy cow, this stuff is so expensive. What? Okay, let's just buy two guys. Okay, let's buy quantity. Two. Jeez, 99. Good gravy. Two of those, and some of these, and some of these. And let's get a light shield, I guess.
I obviously can't afford any of that shite. Might be able to if I sold some crap, but, well. Alright, you, I want you to equip all that crap. I should probably be doing this off-screen, shouldn't I? I'll do it off-screen in the future, I guess. Derp. You got those silver bangles. That'll help. Another triangle. Triangle, what a funny word. Very, very nice. Let's sell some of this crap we got. And if you... shut up. Should I even keep the bomb fragments around? Are they ever going to be useful? I got a black shield I'm not using. Black sword I'm not using. Plumed hat. Iron bangle. Leather. Light shield that I can't equip, but I am going to use in the future. Plumed hat. Iron bangle. Leather. Alright, now let's go buy weapons for Palamon Porum, because they only got, like, basic stuff right now. Okay, I'm definitely going to get a flame rod for him and a healing rod for her. Because this upcoming area is crawling with undead, so you definitely want something that does fire, that is like fire elemental. And Palum, Porum, you get the healing staff, which I think, if you use it as an item, casts cure on everybody. Which would be pretty nice. Let's move these guys around so we can get this a bit more centered. Lord's gonna have to do it again in a short amount of time here. I won't say why, but derp. Anyway. Oh, you know what? I didn't sell any of that other stuff. I'm gonna do this off screen. Bye. I really don't have a lot of stuff, do I? To sell. I was gonna sell some stuff and try to pick up some more of that paladin armor, but I can't afford it. I probably should have done more of that off screen, eh? Anyway, over this way. It's kind of a trek to get to Mount Ordeals, but oh man, I'm cracking my knuckles. I shouldn't be doing that in the recording. That's ridiculous. This is Porum, or no, this is Palum. I always confuse Palum and Porum because Porum sounds like a more, I don't know. It sounds like a manlier. I don't know. I'm just talking at my ass here. Ignore me! Man, that red sword is so scary. That Cecil's using right now. Yeah, the flame rod is weak, but it'll come more in handy once we start getting into actual undead monsters that for whom fire is a significant problem. How much does the healing staff heal for? Oh, that's actually pretty significant. That's not bad at all. Domo Voi. What a crazy enemy. Man, Cecil, you're fast. Holy cow. You're so much faster than Palum and Porum. It drives me crazy that Porum's jumping sprite, the top row of black on her outline disappears when she jumps because her sprite's too tall. Like, Porum isn't. Why is she a little bit taller than Porum? Or Palum. Ugh. I don't even want to... Ugh. Die. Seriously. I'm spitting on my screen because I'm getting so into this. Holy cow, Cecil. You're crazy. You're just kicking these Domovo-y asses. Yeah, don't get used to that, though, because the moment we set foot on Mount Ordeal, Cecil's going to be hitting for, like, ones and twos. Because everything on this mountain resists darkness. It's so annoying. Ugh. Man, you know what would be awesome? Would be if somebody made, like, remade Final Fantasy IV as a Dark Souls game. You know? Now, can you imagine climbing Mount Ordeals to become a paladin? Oh! I forgot about that. The Deathbringer, the sword Cecil currently has equipped, has a random chance to instantly kill an enemy when you hit it. Which can be incredibly helpful. How long is this episode gonna go? Go. Mount Ordeal's entrance. Oh, we got this cool music again. And unlike Mount Hobbs, this one's blocked by fire. Palum, this is your department.
Yeah, I know. He knows. Sometimes I amaze even myself. Hoo-wah. Why did I say hoo-wah? That was dumb. Blizzard! Man, it's not even called Blizzard in this game. It's like ice. Is it not called Blizzard? I thought it was... Maybe it is. No, it's just ice. No problemo. What did he do? Wham. Palum, our Delta taught us to be humble. Oh, come on. You can take responsibility for something cool you did. Anyway, let's go, Mr. Cecil. I thought she said Mount Cecil. I would totally name a thing that at about that time. Oh, we're gonna get a Golbez scene. Oh, Rosa. Oh, I'm coming for you, babe. Just hang in there. Come, Scarbiglione. I forgot his voice. I think it was something like this. It was a madly dark voice.
Scarbiglione of Earth, at your service.
That Cecil could be a problem. We should get rid of him before he becomes one. He's a dark knight, so he should be powerless against your undead, but he's climbing Mount Ordeals.
Then he intends to become a paladin.
Obviously, you must kill him before he does.
Do not worry. You can enjoy watching his death, Lord Golbez.
Then go!
Yes, my master.
Ooh. Oh, what the hell was that voice? Holy cow.
This has become interesting. Don't you think so, Cain?
Yes, but you should not take light of Cecil's power.
I understand your respect for your former friend, but I've sent Scarmiglione after him. He is one of my four emperors of the elements. He promised us a good show. What do you think, Rosa?
My master, let me kill him.
Yeah, like you did at Fabul? Oh, wait, you didn't kill him there. So what makes you think I'll send you? Stay here and watch the girl, dumbass.
Yes, master.
Cecil, please be careful. Who are you talking to? Cecil's not here, he can't hear you.
Well, you're a white mage, you probably believe in, like, those kinds of miracles where somebody hears you say something from, like, millions of miles away. And who knows, maybe that actually does happen in this game. I don't know. Nobody cares. Oh, I was gonna end the episode. Oh no, spirits and souls! Oh, this is scary!
That's probably gonna hurt. No, not really. That wasn't so bad. Oh! I didn't expect that to do any damage, but thinking about it, I guess I understand, because how else would you fight these guys? Like, what are they gonna be weak to? What, ice?
For some reason, ghosts aren't susceptible to healing magic like zombies are, and that always confused me, because you would think, I mean, I guess ghosts aren't really undead, they're just dead, you know, so they wouldn't be affected nearly the same way. I'm showing off twin magic here. We're going to end the episode with a bang with some twin magic. Hopefully they get, like, little Meteo. There are two things that you can get, I think. There's, like, little Meteo and, like, little Flare, or twin Flare. Yeah, little Flare. And that's pretty damn strong. I think it does cost a significant amount of MP, so I probably won't be doing that a lot, but it's damn strong. Pepper 31 Gill, 431 experience. Palum gained a level. Ice 2 was learned. Hell yeah. Piggy was learned. Excellent. Palum gained a level. Learned life. Fantastic. Next time on Final Fantasy IV, we'll find what's in this treasure chest. Bye. What a stupid cliffhanger. Do I have to have an at the end of every single episode I've recorded today, I've had this little, like, ending spiel, like, oh, bye. Man, that's awkward. Look at this. This is so dumb. Like, shut up. Just end the episode. Jeez, man. Huh. You did it again.